गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. आफ्टर डिस्कसिंग द ट्रांसपोर्टेशन इन ह्यूमन बीइंग वेयर वी डिस्कस अबाउट द ह्यूमन हार्ट, वर्किंग ऑफ द हार्ट, डबल सर्कुलेशन एंड अबाउट द ब्लड. अदर लिविंग ऑर्गेनिजम्स आर प्लांट्स, दैट हैज बीन डिस्कस्ड इन द एनसीईआरटी. सो टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द ट्रांसपोर्टेशन इन प्लांट्स. हाउ वट वुड बी ट्रांसपोर्ट इन द लास्ट वीडियो वी हैव डिस्कस्ड द जाइलम एंड फिलोम इज द मेन ट्रांसपोर्टिंग टिश्यू इन द प्लांट्स. Where xylem will transport the water and minerals and phloem will transport the food. So, firstly today we will discuss the transportation of water and minerals. How this transportation of water and minerals takes place? We will discuss about step-wise because this question will come in the 3 marks given by the CBSE so many times. So, first step of the absorption of water and minerals is the mineral absorption along with water absorption. As we know, the biggest source of water and minerals for the plants is the soil, because the plants spread their roots in the soil, and with the help of those roots, the plants will absorb the mineral and water from the soil. This water is present in between the particles of the soils. So, roots will spread the root hairs that will spread in between the particles inside the water. So, water concentration of water is high in the soil, so it can transfer from the soil to root hairs from high concentration to lower concentration by the passive transport. Okay. Now, secondly, mineral transport. Yes, concentration in the starting when we plant it, any of the plant in the soil. So, in the starting concentration of minerals will be high in the soil, but as the plant grows, it will absorb the maximum minerals from the soil. As a result, the concentration of the minerals will decrease in the soil and increase in the plant as the plant will increase its size. So, what would happen at that time? Plant will absorb the minerals by the active transport. Minerals absorption takes place only by active transport. Active transport, yes, by the use of ATP. As a result, I have shown a diagram here. Root hairs will absorb the water and minerals, and then water and minerals will pass through the root hairs. This is the cortex of the roots where water will reach, and from the cortex, the water will pass into the endodermis, and from the endodermis, water will reach to the xylem. And xylem is the main water conducting tissue. So, minerals absorbed by the active transport with the help of ATP, and absorption of water will take place by the passive transport from high concentration to low concentration. Where is the high concentration? Soil. And low concentration will be inside the plant without involvement of the ATP. Now, third point you can say ascent of cell. What do you mean by ascent of cell? Upward movement of water. Upward movement of absorbed water, which contains the minerals also. That is known as the ascent of cell. This ascent of cell also result in the transpiration, because maximum 98 to 99% of the water that is plants absorbing from the soil, they will lose with the help of transpiration process. Why they are losing and what is this transpiration? Transpiration, the process in the plants where plants can lose maximum of their water in the form of water vapors from the surface of leaves is known as transpiration. That means loss of water in the form of water vapors from the surface of leaves called transpiration. Transpiration can take place with the help of stomata or can take place by the cuticle. So from both the sides plant will lose the water. And why this transpiration is going on in the plants? Yes, it is very important process, because without the transpiration, plant cannot absorb the water and minerals first thing. Second, it will maintain the cooling or homeostasis in the plants, which is required for different working of the plants also, because a normal temperature of any of the plant is required to perform the various activities in the plants. So, but now question arises, whenever we are at the homes also, when we have to transport the water on the roofs, we are using the motor. Then how this water transfer from the soil to different parts of the leaves without any motors? This question is arise. So this is only possible due to transpiration pull. Transpiration pull. Transpiration pull. What do you mean by transpiration pull? It means when transpiration will take place, this is the part of the leaf. When transpiration will take place, so maximum water will be loose from both the sides. As a result, concentration of water will be less here. And so if the concentration of water will be decreased here, this part will absorb maximum water from the xylem. And as a result, from where the xylem will absorb the water? From the roots. And roots will absorb from the soil. When these parts create the high concentration of the water, as a result, maximum of the water from the xylem will be sucked by the suction pressure will be created, that will suck maximum of the water in the leaves. So, xylem will transport maximum of the water. As a result, in the xylem, negative pressure will create. And how much is it? 10 to 20 atmospheric pressure will be created in the xylem, that is responsible, and that will be occur only due to the transpiration, because this process is very important for the plants. So as a result, this is when water will transfer, what would happen? Xylem will be empty? No. At that time, what would happen? Pressure will create here, and at the same time, root starts to absorb water from the soil. So there are two forces that will take place in the plants, that are the cohesion forces and adhesive forces. Cohesion forces will between the molecules of water. Cohesion forces will take place between the molecules of the water, and adhesive forces will take place between the molecules of water and the walls of xylem. Have you noticed? So whenever you are taking the bath, a number of water droplets will attach on your face. With what type of forces will apply there? Adhesive forces between the water and our face. Same like water droplets attach on the walls also, on the other articles also. That is only due to the adhesive forces. So when water is going, the water channel will be continuous. It will not break, because water will move continuously. And in between the water molecules, there are the cohesive forces that will not allow to break the bond between the water molecules. So whenever you fill any of the utensils of the water and throw the water, water will move continuously only due to the cohesive forces. In the same way, water will move here also continuously without breaking due to the cohesive forces, and it will attach in the xylem by the adhesive forces. But if we will discuss about the transportation of the food, where the food will synthesize? Food will synthesize in the leaves. Food will synthesize in the leaves, that is the organic matter, glucose or the starch, and that has to be transferred to the different parts of the plant. So transportation of food will take with the help of phloem in both the direction, as upward as well as downward direction. For example, roots cannot make their food, so they will take the food that is prepared by the leaves only. So food will synthesize inside the mesophyll that contain the chloroplast, because chloroplast are the kitchen of the cells, and where photosynthesis will take place. By the photosynthesis, food will be prepared, and from the xylem vessels water will be mixed, and that food contain the water called the food sap, phloem sap, that will be transferred with the help of sieve tubes, and that sieve tubes will transfer the food in different parts of the plants on the basis of their requirement. Thank you.